Do you receive a deposit statement twice a month from Amazon that explains what they put into your account? Well, then you should record that into QuickBooks Online in the way that we will learn in this video. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What exactly happens in an Amazon online store? Well, you purchase the merchandise yourself, independent usually of Amazon. You arrange shipment to the storage location that you keep it before you physically sell it to the customer. You list the products for sale on your Amazon online store, and the customer orders a product from your Amazon online store. Then you arrange the shipping through Amazon. Then the customer pays Amazon, and Amazon releases the money to you after deducting the fees. Then you get a statement from Amazon explaining the amount of money they deposited into your account. So what do you need to do in QuickBooks Online when you get the statement? Well, you need a chart of accounts that includes each item listed on the bi-monthly Amazon statement. And then you also need all the other normal banking related features in QuickBooks in order to manage your general administrative expenses and record actually purchasing the merchandise. Don't worry, we will get an overview of all of those things in later videos. But what specific accounts do you need to have in your chart of accounts to be able to record the bi-monthly deposit? Well, in the video that was before this one, the prior video, we already demonstrated how to record each of these seven accounts into the chart of accounts in QuickBooks Online. So if you missed that video, I suggest you review it and go ahead and add each of these accounts in the way that we already did so that we can record the information directly from your Amazon bi-monthly deposit statement. Now, here's an example of an Amazon bi-monthly deposit statement. If you look at the bottom left, you can see that this is somebody's Amazon deposit statement that was deposited on April 3rd of 2019, which is the first month that we're dealing with in this course. Now, of course, it looks like somebody took a bad picture of it with their phone. I don't know who, but you will notice that there are numbers with little red dashes next to them. I put them there because I wanted to clearly distinguish between the positive numbers and the negative numbers on the statement. Notice this person has $6,655 withheld from the previous month that Amazon calls an unavailable balance. And some of you are required to have that, I assume, until you build up credit with Amazon. Then, of course, we have the product charges, which is your main income. And everything that has a red dash next to it also has a minus sign. That means if you printed the statement in color, the items with the red dash next to it would print in red. And if you zoomed in more closely, you would see they have a minus sign. The way we record this in QuickBooks Online is to use the Make Deposit window. Each entered number on the statement one by one must be either positive or negative. And if it's listed as negative on the statement, then you have to enter it into the deposit window with a minus sign. Do not enter subtotals, and guess what? That's it. Just read each line from the statement into the deposit window and make sure the negative numbers are negative and you skip the subtotal numbers. So, let's zoom in on the top half of this statement and enter it into QuickBooks Online exactly how we see it. Now, before we record from the statement, let's just click Reports, Custom Reports, and confirm that we're starting with all numbers equaling zero. Reports, Profit and Loss, all numbers equaling zero. Now, how do you record the deposit? In the top left, you click New, and all the way to the right, you click Bank Deposit. Now, the date that Amazon deposited the money from this particular statement was April 3rd of 2019. And you can leave received from completely blank because you know you received it from Amazon. The first account that you choose will be the first item listed on the statement. And the first item listed on the statement as a positive number is the unavailable balance 665597. Oops, let's go back a little. Okay, 665597. So you will choose unavailable balance, which is the account we put in the previous video, 6659. Is that right? 6659? 665597. Excuse me. 6655 and 97 cents. Now, after you type the number in the field, go to the left of your keyboard and push Tab. When you keep pushing Tab, it will create the next line. You can tab over to Account and simply put in the next number. The next number is your main income, product charges, 13796.22. So we choose the income account, product charges, 13, look at the short-term memory here, 796.22, 13, okay, and then again, after you type the number, push Tab until you create another line. Now, the next line is interesting. Promo rebates goes in as a negative number, negative 328.36. So we come here and we choose. By the way, if you type in the first two letters of the name of the account, QuickBooks Online will filter it so you can find the account more quickly. Promo rebates, negative 328.36, negative. Push Tab until you go to the next line. So what's the next one? The next one is Amazon fees, negative $5,003.64. So we type in AM so that it filters it, Amazon fees minus $5,003 and what was it? 64 cents. Push Tab until you get to the next line. What's the next line? The next line is other, and it's a positive number. So even though you listed that as an expense, you will still type that in as a positive number if that was what was listed on the statement as a positive number. 428.99. Other, positive, and keep pushing Tab until you get to the next line. Okay, now product charges down here is now again listed as a negative. And even though you used it once, if Amazon listed it again, then you have to enter another line exactly as you see it on the statement. Product charges negative 137. So, product charges, negative 137. And keep pushing Tab. Now, what's the next one? The next one was promo rebates as a positive 599. So that's what you type. Actually, was that negative or positive? Hold on. That was positive, so you have to be very careful. That one mistake will throw off the total at the bottom, and you have to confirm that you're correct by matching the total at the bottom. So what's the next one after Amazon fees as a positive $15.59? So you have to record that. Positive. Okay, what's next? Then other as negative 672. So okay, what's next? Well, we've done everything in the top half of the statement, so let's record from the bottom half of the statement. Subscription fees, negative $39.99. Exactly as it's listed on the statement. FBA fees, negative $138.40. Exactly as it's listed on the statement. Cost of advertising, $131.76. Is that negative $131.76? Let's confirm. Yep. And now skip the subtotals. You have another other for $200.60 positive. So and that's a positive number on the statement, so you put it as positive in your deposit. Now, it does give you a total balance of $15,371.49. So you have to confirm that by scrolling all the way down. I put in a wrong number, and if it's transposed, I'm going to pause this video and find out which number I transposed, because I know that this is supposed to be 71 instead of 17. So let's take a look at which number I did wrong. And what I found by looking more closely is that on line number 5, I transposed the 2 and the 8. It should be 82 and push tab. Now that I corrected the mistake, if I scroll all the way down, $15,371.49 is the total deposit so far, and that's what it gives me as the total deposit on the second page here. Total balance, $15,371.49. However, that's not what they deposited on April 3rd. They only deposited $9,657. Why? Because they withheld this $57,1372. So now we will put that back in unavailable balance by recording it exactly as Amazon listed it on the statement with a negative number. The unavailable balance at the bottom is what they subtract out, and we put it as negative. Negative 571372. Negative 57. Now let's look really close. 1372. 57. And after we push the final tab, you will see the actual amount that is deposited into our bank account matches exactly what Amazon tells us at the bottom of the statement. Now, all we have to do is click Save and Close, and we have a little too much detail in this profit and loss. So let's click back reports and go to the custom reports, the trial balance, and you can see that cash and bank is exactly the amount they deposited. The unavailable balance is simply the difference between the amount they gave us from last time withholding deducted from the amount that they withheld this time. And you can see the income and expenses listed here. Now, it's better than the detail. It's better to click reports, standard, and go down to just the regular profit and loss. Click regular profit and loss, and you can control the to and from dates. But if you click the date pull down and choose all dates and click run report, you can see just for April of 2019, your net income was $8,715.52. And that's because you earned $13,659 in income and Amazon subtracted all these expenses. So your real profit from that statement was $8,715, even though the amount that they put into your bank account was $9,657, because the difference really is the unavailable balance, the difference between what they remitted from last time deducted from what they withheld this time, because that doesn't really count as part of your income and expense. That's why the amount of deposit was a little bit different than your net income.